We got D-Day coming up. It's going to be fun delivering the van to SunPower here in Ensenada.
Which is an unforeseen thing, which happens on projects like this.
In the winter of 2020, Root Del Sol faced down the barrel of destruction. Despite the chaos these events have brought, with our technology partners, SunPower and Galt Energy, we're ensuring that these difficulties turn into opportunities to be a better and more united solar community. We're proud to bring you this latest series from the specialist workshops of RRS Race Prep. Together, we're engineering solutions to problems of the past and pushing the limits of what is possible. Welcome to Root Del Sol 2.0. First of all, I want to apologize for the delay in making this video. I just wasn't feeling so good after having to delay the launch of this project for the third time, which I'll explain in more detail later on.
So what we're doing right now is we're going from a 2D sketch in AutoCAD where we could just basically do the whole layout of the solar panels, which are these little orange squares. And that's going to help us do our SolidWorks parts.
Yeah, one of the beauties of having digital stuff is that we don't have to make those mistakes, right? We don't have to do that.
Correct. I mean, we did what we had to do, like, on the basic level as far as framing goes. Now that we have the panels here, before we continue to do all the mating and all the movement and the structure, like the animation that we already showed to you guys, we got to check for interference. We have to check any possible thing that might damage the solar panels before we even start to fabricate anything, because what we don't want to lose is time or put in risk the brand new solar panels we got.
Mm-hmm. After doing a quick fit test to see if our fabrication fit the panels as planned, we then did a stack mock-up to get a quick idea of the new height of the array. After all that, we then moved on to do our first movement test. This was a bit more in depth than placing some panels or stacking some frames. So Hector just tacked half inch bolt?
Yes, sir.
Half inch bolt in place. This is just a mock-up job of what our hinge system's gonna do. And we've just swung it out for the first time. Hector just did, this is hot off of the press, off of the design studio.
We're pretty happy because we did all this in SolidWorks and now we got to do it in the shop, and it's exciting.
Uh-huh. So this thing swings.
You have to take
basically care. Based off of the animation that I've shown you all, this is the first time in reality that we've seen this thing working. And what we're trying to define now is the point at which we need to link these. Basically, this thing slides out and these two are linked together with a pin, a slot and a pin. Firstly, we wanted to go to the DIY route to just show that it was possible. We marked and then cut our slot using an angle grinder. It wasn't perfect, but it worked. After deciding that this is going to take much longer by hand, we moved on to using the depth of tools available to us. RRS is in possession of a rather large CNC plasma cutter, so we decided to use that. The next sequence of shots explains how that was done. The first step is to take an AutoCAD drawing and transfer it over to a type of CNC cutting software. You use this to define your cut and then transfer the plans over to the control unit of the machine. Next step is to define a straight edge to align your piece to be cut along, and then mark your zero point on your piece using the cutting head of the machine. Then all that's left to do is to hit start. Voila, a perfectly aligned cut on your piece. Repeat this process until all the slots are cut effortlessly and perfectly. Unfortunately, this is as far as we got with the solar array for this week. So you'll have to like and subscribe to see it all really come together.
but you get the basic idea of how it's all coming together.
So we're finishing up for the evening. We just had a successful test run over here.
You know, a lot of hours in SolidWorks of just like figuring out the geometry and the pivoting points and how to connect and interact with all the panels. Literally in one afternoon, we didn't have to investigate anything. We didn't have to go trial and error. We just measured it. Every pivot point, every crossing point, it just works. I mean, it's really, really cool to just go from computer to metal and just make everything snap. I think we're 2 to 3 days away from making everything smooth, nice, and on the van.
Ready to go on the van.
Yeah.
On the ground first and then...
Correct. Test every single mechanism on the ground. It's on the shop floor. Check control. Check everything. All the motion on it. And just hop it on.
Get it on there and then start tracking and testing the tracking and all of that sort of stuff.
Correct.
Next up on the agenda is the vehicle's 3-inch chassis lift. The only experience I had lifting a vehicle was up in Canada, when my buddy and I put hockey pucks under the chassis mount to give the vehicle a 4 hockey puck spaced lift. I know, wild, right? If you don't believe me, Google it, it's a thing. Having never performed a legitimate lift on a vehicle, let alone one that weighs closer to 4 tons, I called on the expertise of the professionals here at IRS. After pulling the suspension system apart, we made a super daft discovery. Not one or two of the vehicle's shocks were destroyed. Every single one of them was shot. So we immediately knew that this wasn't going to be the easiest job. These vans are super rare, and finding parts to make them work again is a real problem. So we added that to the growing list of issues and continued with what we could do. First up were the shock mounts. We had to change the shock mounts to a lower position. So Francisco fabricated and welded those in place. Second were the spring spacers. I'll let Hector's other brother, Eduardo, explain to you what you see here.
How big is that? What big? What size lift?
This is 3 inches.
A 3-inch lift?
Yep.
For the rear of the van?
For the front.
For the front?
Yep.
Oh, this is for the front?
Yeah, it's for the springs.
Is the rear going to look similar or what?
Yeah, I think so. Well, it needs to be like level, I suppose.
Yeah. Another 3-inch lift sort of
that's
thing.
Kind of the same.
Yeah. That's cool. It's crazy. Chunky.
Yep.
What gauge steel is this?
I think it's 14 gauge.
14 gauge steel. Yeah, nice. Good work. Woo!
Obviously, not having the ability to complete this job because of the need to solve the broken rear shocks, we decided to put the wheels back on and lower it onto its springs, just to see what the lift did to the vehicle. Am I right? What a beast. I'm sure that clearance is going to come in handy.
It's 11:30 at night, so working late into the night here. Probably going to be a few more of those nights before delivery day. So yeah, we got D-Day coming up. It's going to be fun delivering the van to SunPower here in Ensenada from ORS. Yeah, get excited, everyone. It's going to be real good.
You. Cool.